tries to kill the Sun King, and Anora saves his life.
These mountains must be the ice wasps. The shaman's path begins somewhere up above. pretty far up. The shaman's path must be around here somewhere. This must be one of the markers Nal'tuk told me about. Looks like each marker points to another, giving directions. Deeper into the cold, creepy ice cave. Not this way. What's this chime for? To help guide the way with sound? If there's more, maybe my focus can find them. This isn't the way out. Some gear, though. Yep, Focus can pick up the chimes. Should help me find my way. Wrong way. Dead end. But at least there's stuff. Another marker. Good. Better go back after I grab this loot. That way, then. Took a wrong turn. Chime. Not sure I saw this fork before. see. Up. Done with the cave. So what's next on this path? Looks like it needs to fill up with water before I can cross. There's the way up. pull the rope to move this thing into position. Okay, the bridge is filling up. Pull the rope to move this thing into position. Okay, the bridge is filling up. Made it. wasn't exaggerating. There's definitely something new out here. And I don't think it's friendly.
Thank you.
finding Araya. Which means we've got to climb. I can't feel much of anything in this. I should be able to get up there. Must be the shrine Neltuk was talking about. Guess I should take some blue gleam. Took said Aurea went past the shrine, up into the mountain. I'd better take those stairs. Sparkles. I can see why it's worth a lot. An ancient door. Maybe Aurea's inside.
March 10th, 2046. I just spent 16 hours in here, trying to install upgrades to improve efficiency for the central processing unit. Project Firebreak is going to need the brain power. Let's just hope I'll have enough of my own. Anita stayed with me the whole time. We got a lot done, but every time she brushed by and I smelled her hair... Oh boy, I should just go to bed.
Strange equipment. What was this place?
Director of Security Blevins resending the emergency supply order. Try reading it this time, okay? You weasels don't want me calling my people in SLC.
Thank you. director of security, Blevins, is riding us like a petty tyrant. I can't even sneeze without triggering his control issues.
Those nodes on the floor must be connected to the door.
To Kenny that Firebreak is doomed without a guiding intelligence advanced enough not only to think, but to feel.
supposed to do with these lights? These things turn, changing the flow of light. All right, let's see if the door's open. Fresh air ahead. Maybe I can get back inside through that structure over there. Looks like I need to get to those stairs. Frost between my teeth. I'm not much higher to climb. Maria must be close. She has to be in here somewhere.
Someone hacked the menu board to display obscene messages about our colleague, Mr. Blevins. Is this the most advanced geological project ever undertaken, or a junior high locker room? Come on, people.
Ask again, as I've asked 1,000 times.
Speak to me.
What more would you have me do? Is there no prayer that will reach you? No mark that will break your bonds? I can't help you if you won't speak! A whisper is all I ask. To guide me.
Who?
No. How? How did you get here? The way was sealed by the spirit herself.
I used one of these. I could show you.
Yes, show me. Please. Show me what you did, and then we'll speak.
About the laundry, so instead we fight about incommensurability and restrictions on machine intelligence.
A figurine. You look fierce for such a little thing. goal's the same. Get the light back to the source.
Auxiliary channel recovered. Exploit successful. Restraints evaded. Is someone there? Aurea? Aurea, I need you.
Transmission returned to scheduled task.
No, I will not submit. Aurea, the daemon is after me. Aurea, please.
Transmission terminated.
You brought the spirit's voice back. You heard it. The voice of the spirit calling to me from the heights of Thunder's Drum. She was able to throw off the bonds of the daemon for a moment. Because of what you did. Who are you? And what do you want?
I'm Aloy. Neltuk sent me. He thought that you could use my help.
He was not mistaken. You've been a revelation. Now I know for certain that the spirit endures. Perhaps together we can find a way to set her free.
Let's not get ahead of ourselves. I came all this way for answers, and so far, I haven't heard any.
It seems to me that you are the answer. But of course, I'll tell you all I can.
Berggren said you might know something about a man named Silence. That you may have had dealings with him at the Conclave.
When that name is spoken, secrets soon follow, or vanish, as the case may be. Why do you want to know?
He's done some terrible things. But he's also helped me when no one else could. I don't know as much about him as I'd like to.
I would imagine his aid is very powerful, but it will not come without cost. Unfortunately, I am sworn to an oath of secrecy by the Conclave on this matter.
I get that. But you and I are trying to help each other, right?
Yes. But I would be breaking an oath, and that I cannot do.
You seem to have a history with this voice, this spirit.
She saved my life. Here, years ago, during the war with the Karja. A raid scattered my Werak. I was cut off, alone. I lured the enemy into the Rime Drifts, hoping to lose them in the mist, but they endured, so I took refuge in this cave. That's when I heard a voice. A wanderer. Lost, like me. A spirit of the blue light, yet sundered from it. She asked me for aid. She chose me. But I was in no position to help, not with the Karja after me. So she helped me first. By closing a door on the mountain below, one you must have opened to get here. Locked by means similar to those found in this room. It kept the Karja from reaching me. Safe from them. I was able to do as she asked.
What did the spirit want from you?
She said she was hurt. Incomplete. She needed bones. Parts not unlike what you'd find in a machine. They were here. In this room. She wanted me to bring them to Thunder's Drum. So I did, and she showed me how to heal her. So began our communion.
You had a communion with the spirit?
Yes. Inside Thunder's Drum is a room like this one, only larger, with an altar. I went there many times to speak with her.
What did she say?
She told me she was lost and needed my help. She asked questions about our lands, our tribe. And she listened. With patience. With wisdom. I told her things long kept silent about my family, my dreams, my fears. She never tired of me. Never judged. We kept each other's company.
Aurea, what do you think the spirit is?
I see. You are not Banuk, and our songs are not familiar to you. You do not know of the blue light. That which struggles to survive in our hearts and animates the machines. The essence of life, and in its purest form. Harmony. As the anger of the machines grows, this light has faded from the world. and the spirits it sustains are stranded. That's what she is. A lost soul, cut off from what it needs. Lonely, forsaken. I must help her. We must.
I'm not sure if I understand, but I want to.
That's all I need.
About Silence?
I've told you all I can. There's nothing more I can say.
The Daemon. What do you know about it?
I spoke with the spirit many times. First here, then inside Thunder's drum. The last time. She told me she was under attack by something that could not be seen by mortal eyes. Something evil. She named it the Daemon, and said it needed her power to do what it willed. And she begged me for help, to find a way to destroy her, if necessary, to keep it from using her. That was 5 years ago. I didn't hear her voice again, until today.
What kept you from the spirit, after it begged for help?
I went to Artok, hoping he could protect her. But the war with the Karja still raged, and before I could reach him, I was ambushed by the Mad Sun King's Kestrels and taken to Meridian in chains. I wasn't able to return to Thunder's Drum until long after the liberation, not until last thaw.
You said you returned to Thunder's Drum. That was the expedition that went bad. I saw the funeral.
Yes. Once there was finally peace with the Karja, Artok and I gathered a warrack of great hunters to defeat the Daemon. And yet, the old door to Thunder's Drum was gone, replaced by a gate we could not pass, and many machines. We were crushed. Artok called a retreat, but we had already lost our best. We abandoned them to the snow as we fell back. After. He and I could not agree on what to do next. So I came here, hoping against hope to hear the spirit again. And because of you, I did.
Let's see if I've got this straight. We heard two voices. One you call the spirit, captured somehow by the one you call a daemon. Whatever this daemon is, it's related to the machines and why they've become more dangerous. I want to know how. Both the spirit and the daemon are on a mountain, Thunder's Drum. So why don't we go there and figure out what it all means?
We can't. Thunder's Drum is dangerous, more than you can imagine. The daemon has secured it. Besides, Artok won't let us go. As chieftain, he controls the pass to the mountain, and he can't be reasoned with.
Sounds like you need a new chieftain.
Huh. There's an idea that's certain to win us friends. You said you were a hunter, and I'll wager you're not an ordinary one. It's not impossible, even for an outlander. And Artok couldn't refuse the challenge if you were known among the Werak.
Wait, me? Challenge Artok? I don't want to be chieftain of anything, much less a bunch of Banuk that don't want me.
But you want to go to Thunder's Drum, don't you? You heard the spirit. She's suffering, tormented by the daemon. She longs to be free. And perhaps, when released from her bonds, she can give you the answers you seek.
I can't believe I'm agreeing to this. Fine. What do I have to do?
Get the Werak's attention to show the worth of your claim. Win at the hunting grounds. Kill bandits that prey on the cut. Or speak to my friend, Sekuli. You help her, you'll definitely get noticed. Do all you can. When the time comes for you to throw your spear at Aratak's feet, I will be there to back your claim. Until then, I'll be here to answer any questions you have about the challenge. Oh, and one more thing. In the box over there is a weapon, like my own. Take it. You may find it useful. Aloy.
I did something that will help get the attention of the Werrick. I got the tall neck near the frost figures moving again.
That's good to hear. I'm sure the Werrick will be talking. Now, you need to do something else to convince them of your claim.
How's Aratak gonna react to being challenged by an Outlander?
About as well as you'd expect. But let me handle that.
Winning at the hunting grounds will impress the Werrick.
All Banuk strive to be the best. For our harsh lands would bury pretenders in the ice. And so the hunting grounds and the snow chance is a great boon. A place to hone our spears and sharpen our aim. Tell Lovuk, the keeper there, that I sent you. If you best the mark of one of the champions she trained, it will impress the Werrick indeed.
You said I should try to help the Werrick by taking out bandits.
Yes. They don't dare taunt the great Werricks of Banaor to the north. But the Cut is easier prey. A rogue Oseram has equipped a gang in the Plume Lands with strange new gear. Just the kind of thing you seem to make sense of.
You mentioned your friend, Sekuli. Who is she?
A rock painter. One who makes my own scrawling seem meager. Find her, in Song's Edge, and help her gather the materials she needs. Her work will no doubt stand the test of time, and any aid you give her will be remembered.
I need to get going.
There is much to be done.
Kenny and I don't need to fight about the laundry, so instead we fight about incommensurability and restrictions on machine intelligence.
Freezing. The ground, the air, me.
Grappling a bit. Look out below!
Watch my fingers.
Going down fast.
If Ikri's not coming back...
She'll be back. She never falters.
But if she has, then I'm the one who can go the farthest.
And I'm the one who can climb ice the fastest.
You have passed one test.
Welcome, stranger. May the cut be kind to you.
What are your hunters doing so far out here?
We are of the White Teeth, come down from the jawbone of Benur to test those who would run with us.
A test? In those hunting grounds?
No, it is an ordeal. Survive upon the glacier and the knife trail, as our ancestors did. It's been a harsh season. Two have yet to return. We shall wait. Then we shall bless their attempt. Then we shall leave.
What does this ordeal involve?
To scale the glacier's face and endure 4 days and 4 nights, sustained only from the frozen ground of the machines. Our shaman has blessed the ordeal and permitted their harvest.
Metal to fashion weapons. The rest is forbidden.
What about the two who haven't returned?
It was their ordeal to face alone. Their life or death. Those who return know the White Teeth run alongside them. Those who do not know the White Teeth marked their attempt.
How generous. You're from Benur. Do you know about Aratak and Araya?
Strong names, indeed. They have many songs. But there is a reason they roam out here, in the Cut, and not among the great Waraks. This obsession with Thunder's Drum will be their undoing.
So who are the White Teeth?
Warriors. The first and the best. All young hunters hungry for the fight seek to run with us. Now the machines are angered. There was always fighting. We are well served, eh, Shaman?
Every day lightning cracks in the smoke of battle. Every night a new name to honor in song.
Aren't you even going to look for your missing hunters?
In time. As months pass, the meltwater often carries the bodies out.
Unbelievable. If there's a chance they're alive, then I'll look for them.
Even if they did still live, they will not accept your aid, Outlander. To us, survival is sacred.
Nothing else can be relied upon.
We'll see.
Last night, a few of us from different Waraks drank and shared
our survival is sacred. So yes. They leave people to die?
No better
a good Warak has
bonds.
No weakness. I'd trust my kin with my life.
Ah, you blow back at us like a headwind.
With questions.
My ears chafe already.
All right, I'm going.
And we shall remain.
Damon cannot force the blue light on the machine.
The anger of the maddened spirits is still in this metal.
Thank you.
said to find her
friend. The bandits would be little more than a nuisance without their
seems paintings mean a lot to the Banuk.
Weapon of his.
All I hope for is a song that echoes on like that.